Harvey Goldstein, the referee, signifies no knockdown with a shake of his head. Marciano crowds LaStarza to the ropes again. In these past few rounds, he's had LaStarza pinned in every corner and against every set of strands. Rocky continually attempting to move in and wail away, pounding, pounding. Marciano is a hard man to hit because of his crouching, weaving style and his ever-moving tactics as he shuffles forward. LaStarza ready to try a right that falls short. He's missing. Another indication that the challenger is tiring. With his back to the ropes, LaStarza catches a left hook. There it is. He's throwing fewer and fewer punches. He's badly weakened, running out of juice. Watch this power-packed right by Marciano that just misses. LaStarza fighting back off the ropes. But Rocky's right back on top of him, ready to deliver a pair of crushing rights to the jaw. Once again, Rocky has forced LaStarza to the ropes, and now they're back at mid-ring. LaStarza holding desperately. Look at him grab Rocky's arm. At the bell, it's another frame, the fourth in a row, unanimously awarded to Marciano. And now, round 11, destined to be the final round of the scheduled 15-round bout for the World's Heavyweight Championship between challenger Roland LaStarza in dark trunks and champion Rocky Marciano. LaStarza's handlers have covered his face with grease. He has two cuts, one over the bridge of his nose, the other near his right eye. Both eyes are puffy. Now, when Marciano throws in a left, LaStarza holds. He's a tired boy. Rocky looking for an opening to drop that big right-hand bomb. 45,000 fans in New York City's Polo Grounds, well pleased with the fight they're seeing tonight, many expecting a knockout at any moment. LaStarza wrestles back off the ropes, a game effort, but one that has come far too late here in the 11th hour of the 11th round. Now watch this closely. Marciano is forcing LaStarza back toward the ropes. That's where he caught Walcott, you remember, to win the title, against the ropes. Marciano misses a left hook, then connects with a smashing right, another right, a left, and another right sends LaStarza sailing back through the ropes onto the ring apron. Referee Ruby Goldstein gives LaStarza, who's up at five, the mandatory eight count, forgetting in the excitement that the rule does not apply to championships. Rocky swarms all over the challenger to follow through his knockdown and end the fight. And there it is, the finish. Referee Goldstein breaks them up, sends Rocky back to his corner. Roland LaStarza retires to his corner, a courageous but beaten youngster, a boy who had come on a man's errand and done amazingly well for a while, a boy who thought he could beat the champion because once, 3.5 years ago in the Garden, he had made a close fight of it. That extra detail of police around the ring apron is to ward off a riot like the one staged by Rocky's Brockton Rooters in Philadelphia after their idol took the heavyweight crown from Jersey Joe Walcott. And so Rocky Marciano remains heavyweight champion of the world as he racks up his 45th consecutive triumph and his 40th knockout. He has shed the rust of inactivity and come on to win like a true champion. And those 45,000 fans streaming out into the night had seen a good fight, if not a great one. September 24, 1953, the Polo Grounds, New York. Rocky Marciano versus Roland LaStarza. This was the big fight.